Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Brie and today we are going to be doing another writing experiment. So as of now, it is almost 7:30 in the morning. I've been awake for maybe 40 minutes or so, and really the only things I've done is like make my bed, grab a glass of water, and like go to the bathroom, wash off my face, that kind of stuff. Because I didn't really want to do too much maintenance stuff because of who I am going to be writing like today and her schedule. And if you are here and you read the title, then you know that I'm going to be writing like Sarah J. Maas. Sarah J. Maas is an extremely popular young adult novelist. She is most famously known for the Throne of Glass series, which she started at 16 and was putting on, I think it was WordPress at the time. So she was releasing it chapter by chapter, and then people, like, she just had a really, really solid fan base back then. And since Throne of Glass, which ended, I think it was in 2018, she also wrote the Court of Thorns and Roses series, which currently is 3 books and a novella, and now has, like, an expansion. Additionally, she just came out with Crescent City, House of Blood and Earth or something like that. Crescent City is like the series title, but like everyone calls it Crescent City. So anyway, yeah, it's weird. So that's her first adult novel. But you could argue that like Throne of Glass progressively got a little bit more adult in like its graphic content. Court of Thorns and Roses had a lot more sex scenes in it, and that kind of pushed it into this, like, new adult category that doesn't exist, and now, like, Crescent City is finally, like, officially adult. So, she's just kind of all over the place, but that is why we're gonna write like her, because she is so massively known, and someone that I am hit or miss with, personally, but I just, you know, she's massively successful, so this is why we're gonna try to write like her today. In doing my research for this video, it is very apparent that Sarah is consistent with just a few things. The one thing she always says in most interviews is that her number one job is just to show up to write. And without showing up, you can't get any words down. And she's pretty much, in most of the interviews I've read with her, she was pretty open with like, I might write garbage that day, but at least I got something down on paper. So it's kind of admirable that, like, you know, it is just, like, she shows up and she has later steps to edit and process everything. She also pretty much says that she's not a morning person and that she doesn't really have much of a routine. And I would probably say that she's accurate with that because I found interviews, like, my interviews that I'm taking this day from is between 2012 and 2019. And the 2019 is a little iffy because as I was reading it through, it definitely seemed like it was actually, the interview actually took place in 2018 and it was updated in 2019. So really, I could not find any recent interviews with her, and I'm not sure if she just hasn't done them or if we just haven't, like, she hasn't really had much of a book out. I know she had Crescent City come out, earlier in 2020. And I couldn't find any interviews. So anyway, most of this I'm gonna gander is between 2012 and 2018. But her routines are usually very loose. And she, like I said, she always says she doesn't really have a routine. But from pulling all of these different interviews, I am going to make what I think is the most likely Sarah J. Maas schedule for the day. To start, going back to her not being a morning person, I'm already gonna be intrigued in how this is gonna work for me because I am a morning person and I feel like I'm more productive at writing in the morning if I jump in and get it out of the way. But for Sarah, we're not doing that at all this morning. Instead, Sarah said in one interview that she really just likes to get all of the like administrative and non-writing tasks out of the way every morning. So she usually says, you know, she'll answer emails, review, cover art, interior layouts, tour logistics, like all of these things that are just kind of like stuff that needs to happen. She will get that going. So for this morning, I actually was thinking about it and I do have some just like administrative work that I can do. So first, I know she kind of sort of joked in another interview that she uses her daily planner to plan out her day slash her entire life, and I do use this, and that's what I'm going to do. Now, Sarah did clarify that she will try to plan out things like her writing routines and schedules and deadlines in advance, so that way she does keep herself on track, but I'm just going to write today's day because I like to go day by day. However, there are definitely some things that I'm going to be trying to plan out. There is a couple contests and deadlines that are coming up that I want to make sure I have in here. I have some writing streams that I'm going to be co-hosting with other people that I want to make sure I put in my planner now so I don't forget them. And on top of that, there's a couple live streams that I'm hosting that I want to make thumbnails for and Instagram posts. And I just want to get on top of everything. So I have, let's see, I think I have 3 writing sprints that I'm going to be hosting on my channel. I'm going to get all of those thumbnails done this morning. And that way we are good. We have all that administrative stuff taken care of. And on top of that, I think once I'm done with those 2 things, I have a video to edit and upload. And I think that's where I'm going to, hopefully, we'll see where it goes. There's a good chance that this is all going to take me most of this is going to be about an hour long. Which then, again, I have a lot of time. So if that's the case, then I'll probably try to work out. I'll get ready. I'll do all that kind of stuff. So that's where we're at. So I'm just going to, for now, start planning my day and getting some of my internet stuff taken care of. And then we'll check back in when it's time for breakfast. So wish me luck. Okay, so it is now 8:30. I've been doing some admin stuff for the last hour. Yes. So as far as what I did, I was able to get done. I actually got done quite a bit in that hour. I did all of my thumbnails for my social media for all the live streams I have coming up that I'm hosting. I also added a new live stream that I have scheduled for October 7th with a new friend that I recently made, and we're going to join together. So I made all of that. I made the stream and I sent her the information. So all the information has been sent out. And I also just actually went through my emails and tried to organize them a little bit more because I have so many emails that I want to keep just in case, like when I'm at those places in my writing, I can go back and reference them. However, they're getting to be quite a lot, and I just keep putting them off. So I was kind of going through that and either organizing them or just deleting the ones that I don't need anymore. So I think that's actually, it has kind of helped me a little bit as far as where I want to go and what I want to do and keeping my brain organized. However, now I'm getting really hungry. Usually when I'm up, after about an hour of being up, if I don't work out, I start to get really hungry. So I'm going to go make myself some breakfast. Now, Sarah J. Maas has a very particular breakfast that she says that she uses and eats every single day. And let me tell you, it's not necessarily something that I feel like it would do me well, but we're going to try it. Sarah J. Maas says that she wakes up and eats the same damn breakfast, which is a glass of fresh squeezed orange juice, a cup of English breakfast tea, and 3 pieces of turkey bacon with a glass of ice water. So, I already have my ice water. And I did go out and buy turkey bacon because that's not something I usually eat. And I have English breakfast. The only thing that I'm changing is we are not going to be making freshly squeezed orange juice this morning. We're just going to have the bottled stuff. It is what it is. Just another update. So it is now 9:45 in the morning. We ate breakfast. Maybe Sarah J. Maas was onto something with the whole like orange juice, tea, and turkey bacon because I actually feel really full right now. So the one thing that I'm just going to say about the breakfast thing before I move on is she does say that it had her routine with like coffee/tea has changed. She used to be a coffee drinker. Sometimes she started interchanging them. Like she would have one cup of coffee, one cup of tea, whatever she felt like she needed. And then in the last couple of years, she really just has tea. So right now I have one cup of tea. I do love tea, but sometimes I feel like I need an extra boost. So I am just going to kind of play it by ear. If I feel like I want another cup of tea or if I feel like I need some coffee, I'm going to do that how I feel. Otherwise, for the rest of the morning, leading up until noon, I'm probably not going to do too many check-ins, but this, I'll just kind of give you what my lowdown's going to be. I'm going to continue doing like my life admin stuff. I'm going to edit my YouTube video and post that to my channel to go up at a later date and have that get out of the way. And then I'm going to probably work out and get ready. So the next time you see me, I should be put together finally. And I'll probably take my dog for a walk. Depending on where I'm at time-wise, I may like exercise/take my dog for a walk, combine that all. Like we might go for a longer walk, but it also looks like it's about to rain, so I don't know how that's gonna go. So I might just exercise indoors and then take Aria for a small walk. But I'm thinking by doing all of that, it should take me to noon and then maybe I'll have like a light lunch and that's when I'll get into writing. I'm definitely like excited to write, but I will definitely say like the later that I typically put off writing, the harder it is for me to get into. So I'm hoping that I don't lose this motivation. And I think maybe exercising and getting ready will actually help motivate me, but I'm going to stop babbling. I'm pretty much like just looking through my notes for Sarah J. Maas. I'm pretty much kind of did the morning stuff that she said. So really, We're gonna carry it and finish my life admin. So I will update you guys as the afternoon gets here.
Hello guys, we are fresh faced and clean and ready to go. So I'm about to make some coffee right now and gonna be using my Mousse Munch coffee. It's milk chocolate caramel, highly recommend, delicious. Although according to my husband, it's a little bitter. So if you like bitter coffee, this is probably for you. So just a note, obviously I am switching to coffee. I feel actually kind of okay with the tea, but I feel like if I'm going to try to sit and concentrate for a while, I need the boost. So we are going to make a cup of coffee. I'm going to make like a large cup, but not like a pot or anything. So I'm about to do that. My coffee pot is on and ready to go. And in the meantime, just wanted to pop in and say that I'm ready to get into writing. I finished up my admin stuff. I showered. I got ready. My dog keeps running away from me. She does not want to go outside because it is rainy and she hates the rain. So my idea is I'm probably going to use the Forest app while I write and kind of like do little breaks as I need them because sitting for a long period of time will probably not be good for me. That's why like I admire Sarah for like just powering through things, but I am not that kind of person. So I'm going to try to take as few breaks as possible, but I can't promise anything. But I'm gonna make my coffee and then I will kind of talk a little bit more about Sarah's writing.
Okay, we're back. I got my wonderful cup of coffee, which smells delicious. And I'm ready to write and see how far I can get. It is 12:20 right now, so in theory, my husband will probably get home between 5:15 and 5:30, so that should give me 5 solid hours of writing. We'll see how I make it.
So I wanted to kind of just talk about a little bit more about what Sarah has said in interviews about how she writes her novels. Now, the one that I got most of the information from is from a 2012 interview. And in 2012, I believe that's when Throne of Glass was officially published. So this is probably when she first started getting... Well, this is probably when she got started and was initially entering her career as a published author. So some of this might have changed at this point, especially now that she has a baby. But I'm just going to kind of give you what she talked about in those interviews. First and foremost, I do want to say that she mentioned that she is a one project girl a day. So she is only working on one project per day. It doesn't matter. She said that she won't split, like she won't write one book in the morning, one in the afternoon. If she's working on one novel that morning slash afternoon, she's working on that all day until she feels like she's accomplished what she met. She also said that she doesn't really set daily goals for herself, but will try to at least get 1,000 words down, if, you know, not more. But I guess 1,000 words is essentially what she goes for. So I'm pretty much going to try. I mean, I feel like I will definitely edit. If I have 5 hours, I'm definitely going to edit until I edit and I'm done and I get to my dinner time. Some other things to mention is that she does listen to soundtracks, movie scores, like that kind of stuff. And she actually mentioned that she was listening to the Cinderella music when she first started writing Throne of Glass. And when a different character was introduced in that novel, she was listening to Swan Lake. So that's kind of where like her inspiration for scenes or characters comes from. And personally, I actually also listen to like movie scores and soundtracks because I love that music. So I'm actually going to listen to music today, and it's been a while since I've got to write to music, which I'm really excited for. She also stated that she is a pantser for the most part, and very much like me, she kind of gets these ideas really formed in her mind before she sits down and writes them. So she doesn't really outline a lot, but she will have a lot of this kind of ruminating in her head. She did mention that once she comes to, you know, deadlines and sequels, that she started outlining a little bit more, but for the most part, she is a pantser, and that's essentially how I am too. I have a general outline that I'm working on, but for the most part, I'm just kind of changing my edits as I go. Sarah also mentioned that like the only writing quirk that she really has is that she keeps a mirror on her desk or behind her so that she can kind of mimic facial expressions. So I'm not gonna keep a mirror, but I do actually use my own videos as well as my computer camera to kind of mimic stuff sometimes, like, because when I'm writing, I do kind of act out some of the things that they're doing. So in the same sense, I already kind of do that, but I'm going to just kind of tweak it to benefit me and where I'm actually stationed in. She also writes in her office, and it's just weird how much we have in common, because she specifically said that at her home office, she's made it into her sanctuary, and she keeps like all of her like nerdy stuff, her inspiration, things about Star Wars and other knickknacks. And like, that's the only part in her house that is kind of like this fandom sacred space. And you know, that's also true for me. So I'm not going to be leaving my office while I'm writing today. I'm going to officially stay in here and we're writing. And the last bit of information, back in 2012, Sarah used to use strictly Microsoft Word. I don't know if that changed. I haven't checked. But for me, I don't have Scrivener at this point. And at the time that she made this interview, she didn't use it. But I'm going to be using Google Docs. It's pretty comparable to Microsoft Word. I just don't have the Microsoft Word program on my computer to use that. So we are going to be using Google Docs. And we're going to go from there. So that's just some more information about how she has written, where she writes, all that information. I'm going to stop babbling because I really need to get into writing, and it's 12:25 now and we are just going to go for it. So wish me luck. I will kind of come back before dinner just to wrap this video up and tell you what my thoughts were on this process.
Pandora. Okay, here's something cool, so you might want to keep listening. If you click the banner on your screen, you'll get a free month of Pandora Music.
All right, everyone, it is 5 o'clock and we made it. So, oh man, this was such an interesting day. As far as what I personally did, I ended up editing 2 chapters, which I'm pretty excited about. I edited two full chapters and I ended up adding quite a few words in. When I'm looking at my word count, I probably added between 1,000 and 1,500 words. I was ashamed because my mission was actually to write down where I was starting with my word count before I actually started writing. And then I just got really excited because I wanted to write and I didn't do it. But I'm going to guess that's a pretty fair assessment because I started with 65,000 something and I'm now at 66,618. So definitely added words as well as edited two whole chapters and started on chapter 10. So we did quite a bit. I don't know. Like I said, I'm pretty happy with where I ended up. And yeah. So what do I think about Sarah's routine? As it's 5 o'clock now, my husband is coming home from work. He is bringing dinner home with him because he is very kind. And I am definitely rewarding myself with the food because I struggled, honestly. While I think I did a lot of great work, I couldn't stay focused. By the first, I think I sat down for an hour and a half straight from 12:30 to 2. I was pretty great. Around the 2 o'clock mark, I started getting a little bit antsy. I went to the bathroom, I filled my water, I came back down. And then by 2:30, I was like, okay, I need to take a break because I just can't concentrate anymore. So I was going to go and maybe, I didn't know what I wanted to do. I didn't know if I was going to clean. I didn't know if I wanted to play a video game, if I wanted to read. So I did turn my PlayStation on and I updated a game and then I played two rounds and then quit because I really wasn't in the mood to play at the point. But that took a little bit longer because my game had to update and I ended up taking a break for about an hour, which wasn't intended, but that's what happened. And then I came back about 3:30 and wrote for another solid hour. And then I took another small break and put the dishes away. And for the last like 20 minutes, like from 4:40 to 5 o'clock, I just kept editing a little bit more, which got me into my chapter 10, but not completing it. So what are some of my thoughts about Sarah J. Maas's routine? For the most part, I think this is the type of routine for someone who, if they have a day job that's pretty like normal standard, writing later in the day and if that's the only time they have would make sense for them. This is also the routine for people who aren't morning people. For me, it was a struggle. I started losing focus in the afternoon. I'm starving now and I was trying to minimize my distractions. Even with coffee, trying to kind of keep my focus, it just didn't work. I was getting antsy. I just wanted to do other things. And I really think that's a big part for me because, as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, I like to kind of get my word counts and my edits and whatever I'm doing for the day in my writing world in the morning. And for my personal life, I have a job that I go see clients as a therapist. I go out to their homes and I kind of interact with them personally. And a lot of them I see later in the day because they also have jobs. So mornings work really well for me to kind of get my creative juices flowing. And then I get to go to work and kind of do that. And by the time I get home, I'm relaxing. So this shift in how I write was not the best for me. But I can see it being very productive. And if I had, I'm thinking back to when I used to be a cook and I would get up at like 5 a.m. and go open the restaurant. This would be a great routine for that kind of work because I would work from like 5:30 until 1, come home, shower, and then I would still have a good chunk of time where I would be waiting for like friends and family, my husband, whoever, to come home because they would still be at work. So if I was still on that schedule, this type of, you know, routine where I would get my stuff done in the morning and then go to write in the afternoon probably would be effective. But as it stands, I really struggled with this writing experiment. I still did it. I made time, but I was unable to fully sit for 5 solid hours and write like Sarah J. Maas says she does. So that's just kind of it. I mean, I think it was productive. I did get a lot of things done today. It just seemed really slow and disjointed for me as someone who likes to get everything done in the morning and then kind of save some fun things for later in the afternoon, almost as a reward. But With that being said, pizza is on its way home to me. I'm gonna call this day a win. I was productive. I wrote, I edited, I did great things in the morning, all for my YouTube stuff, and now it is time to relax. So I just want to say thank you so much for sticking around and watching this writing experiment. It was definitely interesting and very much out of my comfort zone for what I'm used to and what I know works for me, but I am totally down for trying new things. So with that being said, let me know if there's anything in this video that resonated with you, anything that you might want to pick up and try yourself. And if there's anyone that you would like me to research and find what their writing routines are and maybe make that a next video down the line, let me know. I would love to try other authors' routines and see how they may or may not work for me. But until next time, I'll see you then. Bye.